G'day, welcome to stage two of the Giro d'Italia. Time trial over there in Ischia. We're on the ferry now. Seems really nice, you know. It's been a bit of a hassle. You know, we've had people up to the middle of the night, up since 5:30 this morning trying to get this organised. But hey, anyway, this is the Giro. Feel a bit like that Leonardo da Vinci bloke on that boat movie. We're enjoying it, so Brown is over there enjoying it as well. Have a good day.
Stage two, Giro d'Italia, team time trial. Everyone thinks team time trials are about the big things, the bikes and the wheels. That's where they're wrong. It's about the little things. You arrive here, you park the bus. Where do you park the bus? Well, what you do is you take out your phone, you turn on your compass app, you find which way north is, which way west is, which way the sun's going, and you park the bus in the shade. Preparation and timing. It's all about timing. You gotta know what you gotta do and when you gotta do it. And what do you think? Riders walk around with watches? We've got that taken care of too. Not just one clock, but two clocks. Fifth of May now, we're into the European summer. Real important to start keeping things cool. Miha and the rest of the Swannies here do an excellent job of putting plenty of ice in the coolers. We've got towels there to keep the guys fresh on the home trainers. Most important of all, industrial size fans.
Just going out in the start of the recon. So we're basically going to go ride the circuit. We've seen it with our technicians have videotaped this a few months ago. So we know by video, boys are getting their first feel of it now. We'll go out, do a recon, come back, make some final adjustments on the bikes, on the technique, and then it's race on.
It's a sketchy one. It's a little bit climbing in the beginning, but afterwards also you have to do some descents. And with a few sketchy corners in it, so.
Pete's good at descent, so
yeah,
we all know that, he'll be right.
But I think he's going to drop me already in the first part, so then I can do as good as possible descent as if I want, but he's too fast anyway, so.
Good work, guys. Okay, come on, that's it. Come on, what a beauty here. That's it, great work, Ben. Hang on, guys. Here we come. Wait for a second. All the way to the line, guys. That's it. All the way. Great work. Come on, all the way.
We finished the TT. Like always, it's hard, you know? Jens, Morris, Lancaster, and Tuff did a great job in the beginning, and yeah, we did it afterwards, but you know, it's always hard, you know. We almost crashed also in the corner to the left. It's pretty close, so we were pretty lucky. And good, all good.
Got to say, full credit to the boys today. We had a fair bit of discussion through the start of the day, how the tactics were going to go out, how the turns were going to go. And I sort of said, look, we're going to try something out there a little bit different. Just a couple of blokes doing turns at the start, another blokes at the finish. boys didn't want to do it, but they ended up, I sort of convinced them, or whatever you want to say. They went with what I said. Might have been a bit of a mistake, but bloody full credit. They did what they had to do. Might have to go back to the drawing board, but they did what we asked them, and it wasn't to be. Stage three is going to be a ripper. It's a really hard start, up and down right from Sorrento at the start of the day. And then the finish has actually got a couple of lumps, maybe a little bit too hard for Lee and Gossie to get over to the finish. We don't know. We'll give it a go, and otherwise we might play our cards with somebody else. See you tomorrow.